the Smyrna Air Show. I came down to see my brother, and we're getting ready to watch
some Hornets.
They got them blue angels going out there to fly around. They're gonna do some acrobatic maneuvers. I think is what they're gonna do
that's
right
what
now.
What they're doing with the jets?
Yeah, that's right. Time for some viewer mail. Kyle writes, "Hey man, I just subscribed to your channel a few days ago and managed to watch about all your videos so far. I'm 19 and have my own mowing business that manages about 50 lawns, and I'm trying to build it into a bigger company and include more services and upgrade equipment. Right now I run two John Deere zero turns, a John Deere 2520 with loader, mower, and snowblade. Three steel weed whackers, bush trimmer, chainsaw. I love the steel equipment. I've been mowing for 5 years and find they hold up great. My dad has a plow for his truck and he helps me out and helps me run it. I was wondering what your mower height is. We mow at 3 inches and find that it works well for us. Also, have you ever thought about going to Ventrac mowers? I would like to move to them someday, but they have a big price tag. Last question, I swear, do you guys do stump removal? I want to get into that and feel that where I live, there's a lot of money to be made." Well, those are great questions, Kyle. I really appreciate you writing in. That's a lot of questions, so I'll try to answer them all. It sounds like you got a pretty good inventory of equipment right now. As far as the mowing height goes, we generally, unless we're on one of our athletic fields, we generally try to stay around about 3.5 inches, give or take about a quarter inch, depending on the conditions. Springtime mowing here in Central Ohio, where we're located, that can be very difficult at times to get even to 3.5. You always want to use that 1/3 rule. I've referenced that in the past. Be sure to take no more than 1/3 of the blade of grass off at one time. As the season kind of goes on and you get into the fall, what we like to do is we try to get it down to about 3 inches, maybe 2 3/4 for the winter time. But if you're mowing at 3 inches, if that works well for you, I'd stick with it. You just want to watch that in the summer hot, dry months. The shorter you have it, the more likely that grass is to dry out and burn out quicker. If you keep it a little bit longer, around 3.5 or so, you'll find that it maybe stays a little bit thicker, a little bit greener, and it's just overall, it's better and healthier for the grass. As far as ever going to Ventrac mowers, I can confidently say no. Ventrac is a very good machine, as there are a lot of other good machines out on the market. But after all of our years being in business since 1978, we've built our company around grasshopper mowers, and I do not see any change in that in the foreseeable future. They're a great mower for what we do. I'm not saying that it's right for you or right for anybody else, But for what we do, they're perfect, and I think you would find if you decided to switch from your John Deere and go to the Grasshoppers, I think you'll be much happier in the long run. I think you'll find it's a much better built quality machine, and I think you'll find it's a much more versatile machine as well. And then as far as your last question, stump removal, no, we do not offer stump removal. We have a couple other companies in our area that we like to refer customers to if they have stumps that need grinded up. It is a great service to offer, you know, depending on where you live and what your market is. If there's a big high demand for it, it might be something to consider adding to your services offered. The one thing you do want to remember, like I told a viewer mail segment a few months back, you want to be careful not offering too many services because you do not want to stretch yourself too thin. You know, kind of find what your specialties are, what you're really good at. Focus on those things. You'll find if you offer too many services, unfortunately, maybe possibly something will possibly suffer. And you don't want that to do to your customers. You want to make sure you can deliver high quality work to your customers at all times, no matter what the service is. But again, I appreciate you writing in, Kyle. Those were some really great questions. Hopefully those I answered your questions good. Hopefully I answered any other questions. If there's any other long dogs that have any other questions out there, please feel free to write us at stewcare@gmail.com. We'll take the time to read your question, answer your question, and maybe your question will be featured on the next segment of viewer mail. Keep putting those blades to grasses. Should do since it has been a while since we've been busy working, maybe start making like a checklist of what we still need to do before we, you know, tear it back down and send it out.
Well, we basically got a rolling chassis. Mm-hmm. We, why don't you make a list of, you know, we need to, the next thing we need to do is,
like, prioritize it.
We'll put things down, maybe not necessarily this order, we can do it later.
All right.
We need to put the motor back in.
All right.
And the clutch.
We'll call that like the primary drivetrain?
Yeah, because, well, that's, I'm getting to that. If we put the motor and the clutch back in, we can put the chain on to the gearbox, and then we can see underneath, we can tip it up, and we can see what we have to do about steering.
Okay.
I mean, we've got everything wired up except steering now. So we have to bring it from the handlebars down.
All right, so once we get the engine and clutch and stuff back in, I mean, we gotta do steering still.
We gotta get steering in.
Alright.
And then once the steering is in, then we'll know what kind of room we have for the exhaust.
Okay.
And we can take it up to our boys and have them fabricate an exhaust system.
Are you still thinking true duals or a 2-into-1?
Well, whatever they... We'll go with the flow.
Okay.
I don't have any preference, do you?
I like the looks of true duals because you could have one, dumping out like each side here, but depending on underneath how much room they have.
I don't think it'll be a problem because everything's tucked up under the spring.
Yeah.
But we, you know, we got it. Once we get it to the rolling chassis, we can see where we're going to reinforce it.
Okay.
Because we'll twist this frame. We'll twist it.
If we get the engine built up right, yeah, we will.
So
remount the primary drivetrain, steering setup, exhaust.
Okay. And then brakes.
Brakes.
We gotta put the brake rotors on there, and we gotta hook up the brakes. And you got the steering in there, your steering setup.
Yeah, steering setups, exhaust, brakes, finish weld, / reinforcement.
Yeah, frame.
Reinforce the frame.
Then we can take the motor back out and send it to have it built.
Yep.
And it could go to paint. We have to not take it back apart.
Paint and powder coat, yeah.
Yeah.
Tear it back down. Paint
go back to paint. Because when the motor's done, it's painted. We're final assembly.
Okay. We'll worry about the, like, the electrical wiring and all that during final assembly.
That's not going to be a big chore.
Okay. Throughout the line, throttle lines.
Oh, and of course, we got to find a
roll
bar.
Yeah, you want to do a like a wheelie bar?
Oh, yeah.
Out of the back?
I saw one the other day. It's not hard.
Okay.
It just, for looks, for sure.
Yeah.
And I hope if we build this thing, it might be functional.
Hey, you know, I was thinking too, you mentioned wheelie bar.
Seat.
It might be kind of cool, see, on the wheelie bar, if we can get the wheelie bar built, you know, correctly. I thought, you know, because most wheelie bars, like when you look at them from the side, they kind of have a profile like that with the wheel in the back.
Yeah.
It might be kind of cool, which with our steel manufacturer up in town that we have now, have them cut us a plate that we could mount here and have it cut out and have mowing panes cut out of it. Not engraved, like actually the letters are actually cut out so you could look.
Can he do that?
All you need it would be a...
That'd make a nice billboard too for a lightweight.
You could do that, and you could even do a double backing, have it cut out in steel, and you could do like a white and a green.
Or it'd have to be light.
Oh yeah, you just do
aluminum.
Do like a really thin aluminum or something, because you're already doing the diamond plate accents here, but you figure you could do like two pieces of aluminum, have one piece be white, and the other piece be green. So the white letter, or vice versa, you would want it.
So one would be cut out and one would just be a backing.
Correct. So the mowing pane letters,
yes.
You know, you could do a white backing and that's
or
solid.
Or lawn dogs.
But you could have like, you know, kind of like a double layer so your letters are cut out so it you know, it kind of gives like you said, almost like a rolling billboard for something.
So you'd have one on each side.
Yeah, there'd be one on each side.
They just can't be heavy.
No, just lightweight.
That's the purpose of it.
Yeah.
But if it's aluminum, two steel and aluminum.
Yeah. Because we're going to do really thin diamond plating so we can form it around there. So, yeah, everything's going to be really lightweight. The framework of the wheelie bar is going to have to be kind of stout, though, because you want it to function. But, yeah, that dress-up piece can be just thin. It's just, you know.
I forget where I was that I saw a wheelie bar on something, and it was really not a lot to it. It looked nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's cool.
It made it look longer, too.
Yeah.
Of course, when you get hood on, it'll be all right.
So I think that's pretty much it. The primary drivetrain, which is your motor, clutch, chain, all that good stuff underneath. Then we can get the steering set up, which you know, we're thinking like handlebars, right?
Handlebars,
like some dirt bike.
With a dirt bike throttle.
Like, you know, your throttle and your brake here. Like on the bike, the handles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, one will be the throttle and the left will be the brake.
Yep.
And
you want them kind of, you don't want them real high. I mean, you want them...
Yeah, well, we
you
can do
right
that with
here.
The bar. We can adjust,
yeah,
that with
adjust
the bar.
Yeah, adjust the bar. Then once we get the steering set up, take it to the exhaust shop, have them build the exhaust, get it back.
Yeah, because he's got to be able to see what space he's got.
Yeah.
Because we want it tucked under there.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, we'll just have to pick their brain then.
Yep. Well, we'll get on it. It's just,
okay.
We'll get on it. That at least gives us a list to work on.
Yeah.
Like
yeah, leave that up there too.
All right. Sounds good.
You want to talk under here then?
Yeah, go ahead and put it back in the garage.